легенда ЦСКА, двукратный чемпион Евролиги в составе нашего клуба, а ныне генеральный менеджер клуба НБА, New Orleans Pelicans, Траджон Лэнгдон. Привет, Траджон.
Привет, привет.
Расскажи, пожалуйста, ты где сейчас находишься?
Да, сейчас я в Орландо, хотел... называется Yacht Club в Disney с командой Pelicans. Это вчера был первый день в карантине и сегодня второй. И я надеюсь, что завтра будет не карантин вообще. И я могу... входит камера.
Все ли игроки New Orleans Pelicans будут играть?
Думаю, да. Сейчас, сейчас да. Но кто знает, что случилось? Будет 2 недели и 3 игры, и потом начинает сезон. И никто знает, что случилось. You know, we hope everybody will be okay. As for now, everybody is fine. We have a full roster, and we hope with the quarantine that the NBA has set up here, with all the protocols and mandates, that everybody will stay healthy and everybody will stay testing negative. But with this virus, it seems to change, and I don't think anybody really knows how it works and how it operates. So. You know, we're going to do our best, and hopefully we can start the season and finish the season with everybody staying safe.
И я бы хотел тебя спросить еще вот о чем. Я видел фотографии, где постелены корты НБА, то есть паркет. И это же не арены, это просто какие-то большие залы для представлений, что ли?
So they have, there are many different courts set up. Because we have so many teams, there's only 3 arenas, true arenas, where we're going to play in. And because they need practice times, they've had to set up these courts in different, how can you say, conference rooms in different hotel spaces. So that's what they're seeing when they're seeing things on ESPN or where people are reporting live. But those will only be practice courts. The main courts will be in actual, the playing courts where the sound systems are set up will be in real basketball arenas.
Ты сейчас следишь за Евролигой и за ЦСКА?
I keep up with the team. I because of the time difference, I don't watch a lot of games live, but I will watch some replays. Yes.
Ты генеральный менеджер команды НБА. Это очень высокий, серьезный пост. Но в двух словах, я понимаю, что это сложно, объясни, в чем заключается твоя работа прямо сейчас.
Being general manager, I think my responsibilities are, I kind of oversee our scouting department, which is international, obviously amateur and pro here. I oversee the directors of those 3 departments. The G League, we have a G League team and their GM reports to me as well. And then I try to help David Griffin in respect, whatever he needs me to do day to day, whether that's meet with the coaches, meet with Aaron Nelson, our performance staff, push culture with our players, work with our VP of player, VP of basketball operations, Swin Cash, with the things that she's doing with player programs off the court. So it's pretty substantial. I have my hands in pretty much everything. So, you know, that goes down to trying to understand how the draft is coming and put us in the proper position to be ready for the draft as well as free agency and gather information. And keep in touch with other teams as well, so we have those relationships if we need to have a trade in the future or just have specific talks around bettering our franchise going forward.
Как быстро ты убил в себе желание возвращаться, как сказать, играть, убил в себе игрока, когда ты закончил сам играть?
It probably took 3 years, I would say, to completely get it out of my system. Because the competitive nature of being an athlete doesn't just go away. I think the day-to-day preparation and training, I didn't miss. I think that was the most difficult thing for me my last year playing at CSKA, was just understanding the older you get, the more you had to do to prepare your body to play, not only to practice, but to play in games at the highest level. And that got to be difficult. But I was able to shed that quickly. But the competition and playing in big games and playing in meaningful games and winning championships, you miss that. You miss the camaraderie of your teammates. But I've been in really good programs or organizations, Spurs, Cavaliers, Brooklyn, and now in New Orleans. I've had really good people, and we kind of form our own team, so that camaraderie is still here. And so that transition that way wasn't nearly as difficult.
Ты дважды становился чемпионом Евролиги в 2006 году, 2008 году. Какой из этих титулов для тебя самый дорогой?
I get asked that question from time to time, and I think obviously the first one you win is always the one you remember a lot. You know, I lost a national championship game at Duke, and then I lost a European title game my first year in Europe in with Benetton. So before this game in Prague, I had lost two title games. So winning this one was a huge relief. But then 2 years later, you win, and then get voted the MVP a couple months after, you know, my first son was born. So it's hard to distinguish or to pick one over the other. They're two that are fantastic memories and that I'll never forget. And you know, winning them with Coach Messina and the players that we had was amazing. And you know, to this very day, I take those lessons learned from those two teams that I was a part of, and I'm able to apply them to the work that I do every day, whether it's scouting or managing people or trying to motivate the groups that I'm a part of. So fantastic memories that I'll never forget and will always be a part of me for my entire life.
Почему ты носил номер 21, спрашивают тебя?
Мой любимый команда, когда я был мальчик, был Лос-Анджелес Лейкерс. И мне очень нравится Magic Johnson, конечно, но я тоже понравился, как Майкл Купер играл. И он... And when I watched when I was young, the three-point shot, not a lot of people did it when I was young. It was new in the NBA, and he was one of the guys that shot them pretty regularly, and he was a really good defender. And I kind of liked the way that he fit into a championship team. And he wore 21, so that's where that came from.
У тебя русская жена, Татьяна, вы познакомились в Москве, в ЦСКА, и у вас прекрасные сыновья. Они уже занимаются баскетболом? Ты думал ли о том, чтобы сделать их профессиональными баскетболистами?
They like playing. They really like playing the game. And they're getting bigger. Both of them like working out. Both of them like playing. My older is a shooter, whereas my younger one likes to handle and pass. Those are the things that he enjoys more about the game. So right now they're having fun. I'm pushing them a little bit and seeing what they can do. But for me, it's if they have a passion for the game, go ahead and play. Tatiana and I have never forced our boys to play the game, but obviously they're around it a lot. And they come in the facility, they go to a lot of games. And so for us, is if we see them being happy playing the game, then I'll try to help them as much as possible, but it'll never be something where I force the game on them. And we'll just see where it takes them.
Да, легенда ЦСКА, генеральный менеджер New Orleans Pelicans, Траджан Лэнгдон, ему пора бежать, так что все, в Орландо НБА скоро играет. Спасибо тебе еще раз, пока.
Спасибо большое, пока.